I was looking, and all of the swamis that you have over in the marketing area, they're all the early ones with the plain muzzles. Do you have one of the versions that had the muzzle brake added to it? I'd like to do some comparison there.
I think we do. I think we do have one, but it's somewhere in deep, deep place.
Okay.
Can I fetch it.
Okay. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Thank you. All right, that's perfect. Now that he's gone, we can poke around the whole place. Come on. So it's definitely a good place to work. The standard break room. Being Finnish, of course.
There's the Simohaya conference room.
As one has. Employee kitchen. Employee dog. Alright, now, here's where we get into some of the important stuff. Varusteleka focuses on both military and outdoor gear, and they do their own brand, their own design items. And this is where a lot of that production design happens. So what we've got here are largely items that are in stock, but also prototypes, things that have been worked on, new products in development. They're doing a battle belt system and mag pouch system, which is actually going to be really cool. Extra features beyond what we've got in most of the available stuff right now. So, let's see. They also, of course, have a substantial amount of surplus for sale in addition to new manufactured stuff. So they have an entire department of purchasing interesting oddball surplus stuff.
Go on.
Sometimes it gets odd. Let's keep going. All right, what else do we have? We have marketing. To me, piles of surplus stuff lying around is the best possible work environment. One of the cool things with their surplus gear is that they really don't mince words about what it's good for or not good for. You may know of some of Varusteleka's previous ads or descriptions for not particularly useful surplus stuff, which, hey, that's sometimes even cooler than the stuff that is really useful. Also a good workplace environment when you have RPKs just lying about. So beyond the writing end of marketing, there's also, of course, the photography end of marketing, which requires a nice photo studio and yet more piles of firearms lying around. Here we go. There is also a middle ground between surplus and brand new production, and here, that's their brand Yama, which is basically new made products produced with surplus material. So taking surplus, say surplus M62 camo, surplus Finnish MO5 camo, and crafting it into brand new items. So they do some of the small scale production here, but they do all of the development and all of the prototyping in-house. So, things like heavy wool ponchos, Rusmashok Soviet backpacks made out of Finnish M62. Who doesn't need an MO5 camo kilt? And so on. I should point out, the stuff that's not actually made in-house is all made in Europe. So it's sometimes a little more expensive. It's often a little more expensive. But it's not your typical sweatshop slave labor junk. All right, let's keep going a little deeper into the back of the store here. This is more the employee-only area. Well, the whole upstairs here is the employee-only area. The marketing department has all sorts of props at its disposal, including, an entire rack of M39 Mosins and a Panzerfaust, because what marketing department does not need a Panzerfaust? Being a proper outdoors company, of course, there's an employee gym with plenty of kettlebells. And then, being a Finnish outdoor company, obviously, there is a sauna. Because of course there's a sauna. There has to be a sauna. I think, frankly, sometimes this gets taken over by the marketing department, too. All right, so where does all of this stuff go? They, of course, spend all the time here developing, designing, purchasing, but it has to ultimately get into your hands and my hands, because frankly, pretty much everything I wear that isn't specifically for the Arizona summer came from here. That's the janitorial. This is the one we want. Downstairs is the actual retail store. Complete with cool wall art murals. I need one of those. All right, now we're down on the bottom level. We have the retail store and the actual warehouse. So, if you're going to sell a ton of surplus, you have to actually have a ton of surplus. Who knows what fantastic, greasy, smelly stuff lives in those very large boxes. We can only dream. Actually, here's a neat thing. They found an entire crate of American unissued snowshoes. So if you're not willing to learn how to ski, that's sort of a tolerable alternative. The typical surplus store, of course, is, you know, one low, kind of dingy shop with a particularly crusty proprietor who's not particularly enthusiastic about efficient operations. This is exactly the opposite, with a selection of huge automated stocking machines. Which are not running now, because I think everyone's on break. But these guys are loaded up with standard size containers with all of the most commonly purchased items, and makes it extremely quick to actually process orders. Frankly, when I order stuff from here, it shows up faster than stuff that I order in the US, despite coming all the way from Finland. Got yet more surplus goodies. guess. Polish, I think. Canteen sets. That is some sort of terrible alpine, old school leather strap backpack. What I really like here is that the old stuff is side by side with the brand new production stuff that is outstanding. So you can have your cool historical kit and then take that off and put on the stuff that's actually really comfortable to move around in. Alright, let's see if we can find our way out of here onto the shop floor. Shop here is just north of Helsinki. We've got mostly surplus over on this side. And then transitioning into Särmä, which is Varusteleka's primary own brand name. Särmä does a variety of things, some of it more civilian type stuff, like the flannel, lots of it wool, and one of the primary concepts that they have is like a 7-layer series of clothing intended largely for the cold weather, which of course they have here, going from base merino wool long underwear layers up through things like combat shirts, woodland MO5, desert MO4, and then heavier layers, insulating layers, snow camouflage top layers, the whole kit and caboodle, as they say. There's been a resurgence. Finland's always had very much of an outdoor sports sort of population, but that's taken off even more during COVID. People can't get together, so they go outside. Going outside in Finland in the winter requires a little bit of gear. In addition to that, they also cater to the military reserve and the active duty military markets here in Finland. Finland still has mandatory military service, so there are a lot of people who are in the military or who stay in the reserve afterwards, and especially the reservists, who don't want to go do their reserve training with really crummy old army issue kit and stock themselves up here. And then we have Sotima. What wouldn't make a surplus store cooler than actually having a bar in the surplus store? Sadly, Finnish COVID restrictions right now have shut down Sotima, but what that means is that Jari doesn't know where I am, and the lights are off so no one can see me. So, alright, I think we can cut that now. The one thing I do want to point out specifically, because I really, really like it, way more than I thought I would when I first got it, is Woolshell. So this is something that they put together that is effectively modern cut and design, but made out of merino wool. So it is warm, it is durable, and it works really well frankly, I think it looks really good. They do these in three different patterns. This is the MO5 camo one with the camo highlights. They also do a plain Ranger green, and they do a dark gray. And this is like the durability and comfort of ye olde wool jacket, but with arm pockets, Velcro for military insignia or just fun morale patches. We've got large pockets on the side. We have ventilation zippers so that if you are wearing this and you get warm or the temperature gets warmer, you can unzip it and actually have some ventilation. A nice deep hood over the top, and they have pants to go along. Reinforced knees, good cargo pockets, etc. I've actually ended up wearing in the Arizona winter, I get a fair amount of use out of my wool shell because it is cold enough, and I've worn my gray one to a number of matches and gotten a lot of questions in the video comments about what it is. So I really like it, and to answer all of those questions, that's what it is. It is Varusteleka wool shell. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed the look. I've been working with Varusteleka for like 4 years now and never really done something like this, and I figured it was definitely time to do that because I really like their entire product line pretty much. And I think you would too. So thanks for watching, and thanks to them for bringing me out to Finland for like 3 Finnish brutalities in a row, and pretty much never asking for anything in exchange.